You're watching One Championship Weekly. One Championship returned to the Thai capital for another blockbuster show with One, A New Breed 2. Fans were in for a treat as the six-bout card featured an explosive main event as Pongsiri PK.Saenchai Muaythaigym took on promotional newcomer Sean Clubber Clancy.
Pongsiri is a very aggressive fighter. Strong hands. He likes his punch combos.
ผมก็มีความแข็งแกร่งครับแล้วก็ประสบการณ์แล้วก็กับโชคกับชอนแคนซี่ครับก็วันนี้ผมคิดว่าทำให้เขายุบครับถ้าให้เขายุบให้เขาหมดครับแล้วก็เราก็มีลูกสองเนี่ยครับไว้เสริมครับไว้อาจจะน็อกได้สองก็ได้ครับครับผม
My advantage is they don't got my heart. There is no stopping my heart. Giving up isn't an option in my head. For me, fight fire with fire. Old school Irish. Somebody wants to go for a fight. Let's go. Let's get it on.
ผมก็พร้อมจะเจอกับคุณครับชอนแคนซี่เตรียมตัวมาให้ดีครับผมจะบู๊คุณแต่นาทีแรกยกแรกเลยครับครับผม
Pongsiri, get ready. I'm coming for you.
We move ahead to the third round.
Jab two from Clubber, left hook from Clubber. Good combinations early on, sets an early pace. Right hand stings Pongsiri. Now the aggressor meter is raised on Sean Clubber Clancy. He knows he's got ground to cover here, Dragon.
Yeah, Clancy starts the round really fast every single time. But in like right around this point right here, about 2 minutes and 30 seconds, Pongsiri is gonna throw a switch, start eating these punches, and trying to pin Clancy up against those ring ropes. And then he's gonna start teeing off on him. Clancy's gotta move around, but he doesn't wanna take a step left or right. These guys only want to move forward. Nice hand combination thrown by Clancy.
Let me tell you what's there for Clubber Clancy. The uppercut. Throw the uppercut on Pongsiri. The chin is there. And now he does it. And you see, he rocked the head back of Pongsiri. The uppercut's there. The opening's there. And Pongsiri has slowed down a little. Pongsiri has visibly slowed down. He's still looking for the elbow, Pongsiri, off the right arm. But Clubber Clancy has found range in the third round so far. This third round is Clubber Clancy's Dragon.
Clubber is an instant fan favorite. He is racking up the fan totals right now with this performance against Pongsiri. He's got to watch that right elbow of Pongsiri. He's got to keep his left hand a little bit higher and fire off those uppercuts because this is what Pongsiri wants. He wants that close range war, but Clancy's got to keep that distance so we can let those hands go. Look at that nice body work to the right hand.
Oh, beautiful elbow. Stunned Pongsiri into the jaw. Just gave him a shave. And here comes Clubber Clancy again. And Pongsiri with the elbow. Clubber with the elbow. Listen to Pongsiri grunting. There's the uppercut to left hook. What a combination from the Irishman. Just take a listen to this. Just take a listen. Can you hear the grunting? Can you hear the power? Can you feel the guts and intestinal fortitude flowing? The adrenaline, the grit and determination through the pores of both of these world champions, Dragon I Can.
Look at Pongsiri just pumping his fist. No, the damage is showing. You can see just Clubber is wearing all those elbows all over his face. Looks like he is... Are we ready to go again? We can't end it like this. We got 35, 48 more seconds. Let's go!
But Dragon, the confidence builder, is that Clubber Clancy has cut Pongsiri. Clubber Clancy's elbows have cut Pongsiri. And here comes the Clubber again. This is a phenomenal main event. And look at those round kicks careening into the forearms of Clubber Clancy. Clubber comes forward. Jab. Pongsiri shoots out the forearms. Can't swim in for a clinch. Clubber wants to get on the inside. Pongsiri trying to maintain distance. Trying to keep the ferocious Irishman at bay. There's the uppercut. Rock the head back again. Locks on the clinch now. A knee from Pongsiri in the final seconds. This has been epic. This has been a war. This is one we will not soon forget. Welcome to One Super Series, Sean Clubber Clancy. No matter the result, you have won over the world, Clubber Clancy. You have won over the world.
Pongsiri put on an incredible performance in round one. In round two, he knocked down Clubber with that beautiful elbow. But then in the third round, Clubber Clancy woke up. And in those last 2 minutes, he tried to put it on Pongsiri, hoping to get a knockdown back, trying to get that knockout. Look at these four, five, six punch combinations coming from Sean Clancy. And then when he's inside the clinch, he's still trying to fire him off. Look at him piece together these shots, cutting through the guard like a hot knife through butter on Pongsiri. What a performance. The first round was interesting. The second round was awesome. And it comes down to the third.
Let's go to Tom Lau and find out our winner.
This match was presented to you by Food Panda. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner from the red corner. Pongsiri, PK.Saenchai, Muaythaigym.
After the break, Superlek Kiatmu Kao and Fadi Khalid battle in an exciting kickboxing showdown. You're watching One Championship Weekly. Welcome back to One Championship Weekly. Superlek Kiatmu Kao and Fadi Khalid clashed in an explosive flyweight kickboxing bout as both warriors battle for top five contender rankings.
Superlek من أحسن الملاكمين في تايلاند. Superlek عنده رجل اليسار خفيفة لازمني ننتبه لها ولازم نحضر لها بالباي. عنده شوية بوكس مش سواء وملاكم قوي وفرحان برشا اللي باش نشارك معاه على خاطر الكومبا معه هو.
ميمات تي ناك لو มีลูกถีบหน้าบ้างมีลูกเตะขาบ้างมีลูกเตะเสยคางบ้างซึ่งอาวุธเขาหลากหลาย
ولازم نكون معاه حاضر 100% لازمني نكون انتبه من الرجل اليسار وندخل معاه في المقابله معناتها نقعد شنو ندخل معاه من الروند الاول ندخل معاه في المقابله ونعطي
طبعا من 3 يوك ต้องเบียดแล้วก็ออกอาวุธให้เยอะๆแล้วออกอาวุธให้เขาเป้า
برشا ندخل المنافسه خلي شي وقت بشي مع شي وريني التكنيك نتاعنا نحب نغلب
เหนือกว่าด้วยแหละครับแล้วก็การออกอาวุธการออก
نحب نقول حاجه لسوبر ليك لاني راه ما يهمتيش في الاسم نتاعك ولا في الشعبيه اللي انت موجود في تايلاند وباش نجيك العاصفه محارب ان شاء الله تكون حاضر.
We move ahead to the second round.
Who won the first round, folks? Did you give it to Fadi Khalid or did you give it to the kicking machine, Superlek Kiatmu Kao? Fadi Khalid opened up like a house on fire. You'll see the intensity build on the kicking repertoire now of the kicking machine. But he's got to watch that left hook from Fadi Khalid. That seems to be the prime weapon that's getting through for Khalid time and time again. And if Fadi can pivot on the foot, turn the knuckles in and catch Superlek on the jaw, he may just drop the Thai superstar. You see Fadi Khalid hunting for that left hand repeatedly. What he can't do though, Fadi, is telegraph that lead hook. You see now Superlek is expecting that lead hook. He's watching specifically for that technique. Outside leg kick from Fadi Khalid. Superlek tucking the chin, got to protect that jawline against the lead hand of Fadi Carlin. They clinch a knee from Fadi. Referee Cal Flynn breaks them. Jumping knee from Superlek. The nephew, of course, of the great Singdam Katmukau. An all-time great, Singdam Katmukau. What pedigree here for Superlek Katmukau. Good double forearms guard against the round kick, and Carlin goes downstairs. The counter game of Carlin tonight has been on point so far. He clinches up Superlek, ties him up. Referee Kaufling breaks them. Carlin coming off that great win over Huang Ding back on August 14. Spinning back fist there, jumping knee! Carlin gets airborne. Some better signs here from Superlek Katmukau in the second round. Unofficially, I will say I did have Fadi Carlin winning the first round, 10-9. Right hand lead there from Superlek. Carlin again clips him with that left hand. He's had more hooks than a tackle box, has Fadi Carlin. If anything is going to drop Superlek Dragon, it's going to be the left hook of Fadi Carlin.
Yeah, he's throwing it with pinpoint accuracy, too. He waits for Superlek to throw that right kick, and as soon as he does, he steps inside, so you can see that he's really trying to close that distance and land that left hook over and over again. It's that left hook of Khalid against the right leg of Superlek.
This may be kickboxing rules. This may be against a Thai star, but Fadi Carlin knows all about competing against the Thais. He moved to Thailand in 2009. He trains alongside the world champion Aliverdi Ramazanov, the great Medi Satut, out there at Venom training camp in Pattaya. And he is putting in a superb performance against Superlek Katmukau. Double forearms guard against that round kick again. Superlek trying to break down those arms. Now many fans around the world. Final round. Fadi Carlin, Superlek Katmukau could very well be one round apiece after two. Tip kick to open up. Good rib kick there from Superlek. Evasion from the kicking machine. Again, winding up. You see the right leg. What he's trying to do here is not only go to the ribs of Carlin, but more so try to break down the left forearm of Fadi Carlin. Superlek knows the left hook of Fadi is the Tunisian's prime weapon. He's going to crack away at that forearm, crack away at that humerus bone over and over again and try and take out that lead hook. Try and get Fadi Carlin to drop the lead hand and then try and loop the shoot around the back of the neck for a head kick knockout. Khalid's got him on the outside. Overhand right from Fadi. There's the left hand. Superlek with a right hand lead. He's enjoyed using the right hand lead all night, Superlek. Khalid tried for an uppercut on the inside. Chance for the knees. Referee Klauklund breaks them. Under 2 minutes remaining, third and final round. Spinning back fist from Fadi Khalid, trying to channel his inner Manson Gibson. Comes forward again, does Fadi. On the front foot as he was against Wang Ding last time out. What a quick turnaround for both of these men. Both of them competed successfully in our One A New Breed series in August. And here they are now stepping up to the plate again. Left hook to an inside thigh kick there from Fadi Carlin. That's the bread and butter combination for Fadi Carlin. He's used it so much throughout his career in kickboxing and in Muay Thai. Like Superlek, he is more used to competing under Muay Thai rules. But he is putting on a superb show against a multi-time world champion. WBC Super Featherweight World Champion, Lumpini Stadium World Champion in two weight divisions, Superlek Katmukau. One of so many world champions signed to one Super Series. Misses with the front kick. Misses with the knee, does Fadi Carlin. Carlin, an intercontinental champion, hoping to break into the one Super Series rankings and get a title shot somewhere down the line. Superlek ties him up. 20 seconds remains. This would be considered an upset, folks. If Fadi Khalid beats Superlek Kepukau, if he beats a three-time world champion, we are going to go down to the judges in Bangkok. Jumping knee from Fadi Khalid, hoping for a final power salvo in the corner.
Red corner, Superlek Kepukau.
When we return, a preview into the third chapter of a new breed event series. You're watching One Championship Weekly. Welcome back to One Championship Weekly. One Championship's A New Breed 3 in Bangkok, Thailand is headlined by the One Featherweight Muay Thai World Championship. Petchmorakot Petchyindee Academy makes his second world title defense against Swedish star Magnus Andersson. Magnus Andersson is on the cusp of fulfilling a lifelong dream. Years of dedication and sacrifices to be the best could finally pay off when he steps inside the one ring.
Fighting for the world title is huge. Getting the debut against one of the top fighters in Thailand, you can never say no to an opportunity like this. It is the biggest you can get in the whole sport, I see it.
Known for his knockout power and epic comeback wins, the Swedish ace now takes his indomitable Viking spirit to the largest martial arts stage.
I will never give up. I get knocked down, I will get back up and I will go for knocking him out. It's like something put me on fire. When I get hit hard, it's like, okay, come at me. Now we can fight. The adrenaline just runs to my blood. In my head, it's more about winning. I need to just win. I want to show everyone how big heart I have when it comes to fighting.
Let's look back at Petchmorakot's first world title defense against Muay Thai legend Yadsin Klai Iwei Fairtex. Let's join the action in the fifth and final round.
Can Petchmorakot go into the realm of legendary status with a win over the legend Yadsin Klai? They tie up early. We really saw the clinch game coming strong in the third, strong in the fourth round. But also I am impressed at how Petchmorakot has been able to keep Yod at the end of a lot of his punches, especially Mitch at the end of a lot of his jabs tonight.
Yeah, especially when he's constantly moving back. We're in the fifth round. It is very close. The chat on YouTube has it absolutely split down the middle. So many people on Team Yod. The other half is on Team Petchmorakot, and these guys are putting on a show. It might come down to these last 2 minutes, Michael.
2 minutes, 10 remaining, fifth and final round. It is going to be razor close. A smile there from the champion, Petchmorakot. He's won championships everywhere. Yadsin Klai too. But this is the most prized. This is the one that Yod really wants to add to the mantelpiece. He's done everything else, Yadsin Klai. But one Super Series gold is something he has yet to attain. Round kick from Yadsin Klai. Off both legs. But still Petchmorakot grinning at him, getting inside Yod's head. High round kick to the air. Triceps there. Petchmorakot on the outside. Look how low the hands are on Petchmorakot. But he's got the distance, he's got the range. Again, the catch and counters from Petchmorakot. You see Yadsin Klai drifting off to his right, trying to cut off the clockwise movement of Petchmorakot. Petchmorakot circling away from the left power side of Yadsin Klai Dragon.
Yeah, but he's also circling into that uppercut. And Yadsin Klai can drop you faster than the stock market if he touches you on the chin with that right uppercut.
Yadsin Klai gets caught, the kick again. Not too many counter strikes on that occasion from Petchmorakot. 35 seconds now. Yotsenfly winds up that rear leg round kick, and again, Petchmorakot catches and counters. Beautifully done. It won't be a knockdown, but it means that Yod has to pick himself up off the canvas. Bouncing around, confidence full here on Petchmorakot, the champion. Yotsenfly goes high with a round kick. This is a tremendous performance from two phenomenal athletes. One who is peaking, the other who many say is in the twilight of his career. Now Petchmorakot dances. He's dancing and centering, and Yod dances as well. The respect between these two, absolutely phenomenal.
And still one Super Series Featherweight Muay Thai World Champion, Petchmorakot Petchyindee Academy.
It's the biggest win of his career. The respect shown to the living legend Yotsenfly from a man who has now entered legendary status himself. Petchmorakot, Petchyindee Academy, retains the world title in Bangkok.
On the 18th of September, Petchmorakot Petchyindee Academy defends his featherweight Muay Thai World Championship against Swedish powerhouse Magnus Andersson. And Capitan Petchyindee Academy faces Petanong Petfergus in a kickboxing showdown. Thank you for watching One Championship Weekly.
Dirt poor.
I've been broke with no money, eating one meal a day after my parents got wiped down the Asian financial crisis and became homeless. Martial arts is the greatest platform to unleash human potential.
No one had ever tried to unite 4 billion people around one sports property.
Our video views went from 300,000 to 5 billion.
And the outcome became the power of martial arts to transform lives.
One.
You will fight your hearts out, show the world why you're the greatest. We'll be right back.